40 years old. Gone. Just like that. Well, I got time. Really?
Come on, brother.
Who told you?
Come on, brother.
You're not guaranteed that you'll leave this place tonight. And all the Lord asks from you is your life. Not the parts you want to give.
Come on. Come on, brother.
Not the parts that are comfortable. Because most of God's children stay within, Lord, I'll give you what's comfortable. But the Lord's asking you tonight, if you want to be my disciple, sell all you have.
Amen.
He said, give me all of it. Give me all of it.
Thank you, Lord.
I want everything that you are. You say, what is the benefit of giving my life to God? Well, are you in good shape right now? Has life dealt with you wonderfully now? Has all your running and rampaging for all the years you've done it, has it got you into a place where you're satisfied and content and thankful? So my question tonight is, what could it hurt?
Amen, brother.
Why not try the Lord? You've tried everything else.
That's it.
You've done everything else. We used to sing a song back in the day. Now, you probably still sing it. I'm trying to revamp some of this stuff in my church. It's like pulling teeth, though. Good Lord in heaven. Some churches is pulling teeth to sing the new stuff. Some church in my church is pulling teeth to sing the old stuff. But it goes, the only real peace that I have, dear Lord, is in you. The only real peace that I have, dear Lord, is in you. Through all life's frustrations, I need you, and I know I do. 'Cause the only real peace that I have, dear Lord, is in you. There's no other place to go.
Amen, amen, amen.
The pill's not going to do it. Drink's not going to do it. The person of the opposite sex or the same sex. Come on, somebody. You say, well, Pastor, that's real.
Amen.
The only real peace you're ever going to have is in the Lord. You say, well, what do I got to do? The first thing the apostle tells us is to repent. It's to come before the Lord. The Bible said, with faith in the heart man believeth, but with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
Praise the name of the Lord.
And if you need to come to the Lord tonight and get some things right and to give him your life, I want to give you the opportunity to do that right now.
Praise
I want you to stand to your feet all over this place if you would. If you have tried everything else and nothing has worked, I want you to come to this altar and I want you to give your life to the Lord. And you say, but Brother Jared, I am in such bad condition. You know what? He accepts us how we are, and then he changes us to be like him. If you're in this place and you need to repent, you need to come back to the Lord, or for the first time in your life, give your life to the Lord. I want you to come to this altar because you don't know what tomorrow holds for you. You don't know what tomorrow holds for you. If you're in this place and you know you're not right with the Lord, I want you to come to this altar and give your life to the Lord. As they're praying with this brother, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Father, I have preached all that you have given to me, Lord, for this evening. And I pray, God, that whosoever heart you were preaching to, God, that they would make their way to this altar and give their life back to you, or give their life to you the first time. And Lord, I pray as they do that you will change their life forever. And that you will give them hope for their future. Forgive them for their past. give them promise in their presence. In Jesus' name. If you're in this place and you need to come to the Lord and repent, you don't know that you have tomorrow. You don't know that you have tomorrow. You need to come to this altar and give your life to the Lord. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Come on.
Father, we give you the praise.